Good morning, fellow Martians. It is a beautiful morning, but we have a problem. We have an incoming sandstorm. So, it is not here yet, but it will be here very soon. And we are low a little bit on the power. So we need to go out and we need to recharge our suit sooner rather than later. So let's go quickly out before the storm hits, and then we will be, I guess, having an incoming storm. All right, let's get out. Oh, look, we could actually continue building this. We have an airlock iris and we will be closing it. There we go. Okay, that's built. Now let's quickly just check what is the status here. How much power is drawn here? We are providing 41 watts here. Low temperature warning. Seek shelter. Okay, let's quickly go and recharge our suit. It is morning. We have to make sure that we are refilled on everything. Come on. Hit it before the sandstorm hits. Replenish. Okay, suit recharged. Good. Let's connect the plug and let's go and check the status of our battery. I just quickly want to go and recharge my CO2 bottle. I did close in this thing and now let's fill up the oxygen bottle. I don't want to go low on the oxygen now. Okay, let's get out. Uh-oh, sandstorm imminent. It's coming. Uh-oh. Hurry, 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 hurry. Uh-oh, it's hitting us. It's hitting us. Come on. Jump in. Jump in. Jump. 3, 2, 1. Come on. I don't want to stay out. Okay. Phew. Okay. The plants are withering. Why are they withering? Well, you know, well, we don't have enough power, clearly, for some reason. We are providing 40 point something. We need 42 watts. What? Okay, well, I know that you guys were saying to me that we should be setting much higher power, and I don't have a good fix. I cannot go outside and increase the maximum wattage. What I can do, I can take down the CO2 scrubber. So if I take it down, the power draw will be smaller. Uh-huh. See, so this is the way that we fix temporarily the issue, so the plants won't be withering. Alright, the plants are actually grown, fully grown, I think. So I think we can actually just wait until the storm passes, and let me just go and check out the window. Oh, it looks ominous, doesn't it? The sandstorm doesn't look fun. Okay, well, tell you what I'm gonna do. I can check the airlock iris, we have one here. And while we're already boxed in, so we cannot go outside, we can take care of our plants, we can take a little bit of inventory, review our technology tree and all that jazz. So, what do we have here? Let's take a look. Technology tree. We have gotten a point in botany. And I'm actually thinking I want to go... Should we take the genetic engineering or... lower oxygen usage? I think I'm gonna go with the genetic engineering, because then we can actually using seeding machine to create superior seeds. Yes, so that's the plan. Alright, when it comes to the plants, are the potatoes fully grown? Yes, they are. Oh, good. Oh, is the sandstorm over? Sounds like it. Let's go outside and check. Yeah, apparently the sandstorm is over. Okay, that wasn't too scary, but honestly, I'm gonna build a ramp, like, right now. There we go. It was a good thing I finished the airlock iris. And look, everything here is right now very dusty, which means I will need my air compressor to clean out the solar panels and everything else. I don't know, do I need to clean these guys? Do let me know in the comments below. I mean, it does look cleaner once I'm cleaning it, but I think I only need to clean the solar panels, right? Well, I hope so, otherwise I'm gonna have a metric crap ton of work done. Okay, yeah, so see, solar panel is right now producing 0.70 kilowatts, and it should be producing 6 kilowatts. So let's take a look, and it's clean. Okay, and now it produces 6 kilowatts. Good. So only thing that we need to do, we need to clean all of the solar panels. Yeah, it's gonna be a tedious job, but we gotta do it, so let's get cracking. By the way, I'm gonna skip to the point when we can actually, when we have cleaned all of the solar panels. However, I have to do it step by step. So, we do have, I think, 2 or 3 carbon dioxide bottles. So, yeah, do I have another CO2 bottle? I have 2, but they're empty. Huh. Okay, so that means I will need to go and refill them. And I have actually deconstructed the only place where I can refill them. I thought I could refill them here. And apparently I can't. I can only refill my oxygen bottle. Oh joy. Yeah, there's no bottles to fill because oxygen is full. Okay, so I need to go back into the base, rebuild the CO2 scrubber, restart it, and then I need to be actually creating the solar panels, and then I need to be creating this, filling the bottles. So, okay, let's go back. Blueprints. Yeah, it was a temporary measure. I mean, I don't like it, I'm not proud of it, but let's go. So what do we have? Where is the... I think it's under resources, right? It's not here. So resources... Yeah, CO2 scrubber. Okay, good. Let us now rebuild it. Alright, we have CO2 scrubber, we have rebuilt it, and now we need to restart it. So... we are starting with an oxygen production, and let's fill the CO2 bottle. Alright. And I want to print another carbon dioxide bottle, just to be on the safe side, because we can then actually... it will be faster to do the cleaning. So, resource inventory... no, I need printer container, sorry. CO2 bottle. And it comes empty, okay. And we have small circuit boards, we have these seeds here. These seeds bug me to no avail. I was thinking that I could actually put them in the seed machine and create something. But alas, no. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go now and I'm gonna go and clean the solar panels. And where is my CO2? Well, why are they empty? Yeah, because when you fill in the CO2 bottle, genius, you have to press it again. Ugh. Okay. Yeah. Well, clearly I didn't notice that my... oh, not the blowtorch, but yeah, it's empty. Oh boy. Okay, so sorry guys, this is my first time where I'm actually cleaning the with the CO2 scrubber, so I need to go... ah, there is the bottle. Okay, so I have refilled one CO2 bottle, but I need to fill the other ones. So let's go. Fill CO2 bottle. There's the second one. And then the third one. We have 3 of them. It will not be a big problem, it is just a little bit of tedious work, but we will manage to clean the solar panels. But I'm more worried that the solar panels are right now not loading the battery well as they should. So that's why the cleaning of the solar panels my top priority. Okay, so how much is this one producing? 6 kilowatts. This one is producing 290. And as you can see, we are cleaning the solar panels. It takes quite a while, and it's gonna take quite a while till I've cleaned all, but I've actually jumped to the point where I have cleaned them all, so yeah, there we go. Alright, good. So that makes the solar panels done. Let me rotate, and I'm gonna build another one. I think I have the materials for it, so why not? We have clearly proven that if we want to build a second workshop in the previous episode, that we really, and I mean really, need more. So yeah, we are still short on the materials. Oh, let me go and print out more stuff. Equalizing pressure. So let's go and print some more. I think it's more glass plate than electronics, if I'm not mistaken. So electronics, we need what? I'm gonna print 6 of them. And I don't know if I need more glass plates. Well, I hope so. Let's see. Printing, inventory, printer container, give me electronics. Alright. So, and what do I need for the solar panels? I need small engine. Okay, I'm gonna print the small engine. Okay, shall I print 2, 4? So I can print 2 solar panels. I do have the resources for them, so might as well. Printer container, let's pick up the small engines, and we're gonna build the solar panels. So yeah, our first half of my episode. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna build some more solar panels. Yeah, nice work, GrunfWorks, really pushing the envelope. Okay, yeah, well, you gotta do what you gotta do. I mean, I have to construct my solar farm because, well, clearly, it was not enough. Rotate. There we go. And let's build. So that would be 2 more solar panels. And I think that should bring our production up to 90 kilowatts. So that's definitely handy. Now let's go and recharge our suit and let's hook them up. Okay. There we go, suit recharge. Now I need the power cable and let's drag it all the way over there. There we go, stick it on. 1, and we have second cable here. Solar panel, another 6 kilowatts. Suit recharged, stick it, and there we go. Okay, will I make it? Come on. Ah. You've got to be kidding me, right? Okay, we managed to connect the plug. Beautiful. Alright, so that now input is 90 kilowatts. And the output is 90 kilowatts because everything is going to the battery. Which completely makes sense. And the battery pack is getting refilled and we're pumping out 45 kilowatts. As said, guys, thank you for giving me feedback. I know I should put the total amount outside. However, I cannot do it yet because I've already recorded this couple of episodes, so I will do it. I think 2-3 episodes down the line I'm gonna put everything out and not worry about the power anymore. Right now I'm thinking I'm gonna go do a little bit of mining, and I need to do also and go pick up these what do you call this thing, the water bottle. Yes, apparently I can talk, I just don't know what I'm talking about. And for those of you that you mentioned that I'm rambling, well, of course I'm rambling, that's kind of my shtick. So yeah, kidding. Okay, so let's go into this and let's see what do we have here. H2O, perfect. Let's fill the water bottle. There we go. Alright, so that's the water bottle picked up. Right, so now let's go and I need to actually find what are the missing resources I still need to build to be able to build again the workshop. Because once again, our task is to build a workshop. However, I need to make sure that I do have this time enough resources to be able to do that. Right, our technological points are advancing and of course we need to take care of our plants. That's something I need to look into as well. It's kind of cool to have two, you know, these ATVs because, well, they're handy. So, right. Okay, so let's go in and let's check our status. Where are we at the moment? It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So I'm actually thinking what I'm gonna do. Radar, let's see, electricity. Structure is requiring 56. Okay, and we are providing, I think, enough. All right, so let me just see what's the status on the plants. These are almost up to 50% and the other ones are done. So I guess the potatoes we can pick up. Might as well actually go and pick them up. I'm gonna go and pick up the small hydroponics shelf so that later on we can replant, but actually I don't need it right now. Let's just go and pick up our potatoes. It looks beautiful, doesn't it? I just want to make sure that I can take a good screenshot because look how beautiful my potatoes are. I'm very proud of them. Let's pick them up. There we go, look, beautiful. Alright, so speaking of the potatoes, that brings a total amount of potatoes to, I think it's 48. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna reinvest in the seeds. I have actually already the seeds from the last time. However, if I put together 2 different potatoes, what I've heard, you get genetically superior potatoes. So that's something that we want to nurture, so to say. So let's say split. I don't want to consume potatoes. Raw potatoes, it's not good. I'm gonna split the potatoes. Let's go and put 28 and 40. Okay, so 20 and 28. So these 28, if I go, I can actually go and... Let's see, we can actually split those 28 into 2 times 14. So I'm gonna put 14 here and 14 there. And look, we get a speed bonus of 3% and seeds bonus of 5%. So we're combining it. Yes. Great. So that will actually produce the genetically enhanced seeds. I'm gonna leave them there for planting later. However, let us go and then take these potatoes and we're gonna split them in the batches of 5. So we have to split 2 times. And it will give us 5 rations, which will be nutritious. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Look, nutrition between 19% and 24%. It's not ideal, but it will do. And that will give us 5 packs of MREs with the nutrition up to 30-40%. And it will give us a technological point within the agriculture, because we have just proven that we can make our own food. Congratulations, we are almost self-sustaining. Beautiful. So I'm gonna need to build a science bench, but for some reason I cannot build it just yet, because as you can see, I want... Yeah, I've gotten also a question from one of you guys. Why don't I build a greenhouse? Look, this is the new tech tree. So to cross into the second tier, I need to build a science bench. And to build a science bench, I need to still advance my technology. So I'm thinking I'm gonna go with a lower oxygen usage. Genetic engineering I have. Faster growth doesn't lead me there. I will research it, but later. So I think a lower oxygen usage would need to be researched. Yeah. Okay, let's go with the lower oxygen usage then.
Botany, technology access level increased.
Aha! So once I researched both, I now can build science bench. Okay, or I can actually research the science bench. Okay, that I didn't know. Good to know. Right, so with that thing being said, let us once again see what are we gonna print. I'm actually thinking of printing a little bit more cable, because right now I really need the power cables. I'm totally out of power cables, and for those I need silicone. So once those get printed, I'm gonna pick them up, and then I need to hook up my rover so it gets charged and all that jazz. All right. By the way, guys, sorry for me talking a little bit more silent. This, as opposed to me recording during the daytime, this is time I'm recording during the nighttime when my kids are asleep, and I don't want to yell to wake them. So, sorry if I'm a little bit more silent than usual. Yeah, alright. So, let's see, where do we have? We can actually build more solar panels, and I'm thinking that's not a terrible idea. I really do want to prepare for the next phase where I can just continue and build the freaking workshop. I don't want to be stopped anymore. So shall we build one more solar panels? I think I have the materials for it. There we go. Beautiful. Can I build one more? I don't think so. However, let's see how is our battery doing. Our battery is now charged. 867. So my calculus is simple. I need to have electricity for the next consumption for the next 12 hours, let's say, because at the 6 in the morning it's the daybreak. So if I have a total wattage usage, and that one is dependent. Let's be safer just first. Okay, what do we have here? Here we have potato seedlings, and they are 45%. So clearly they're not ready yet. So that means I could do something in the middle while I'm waiting for those. I could actually... Yeah, these I have. I could null this, because I don't need to consume more power. Yeah, and just now I notice on the top of this console you also see the power and consumption. Thank you guys for pointing it out to me. Okay, so now let's see, what do we have? Inventory for printing. What should we be printing? Oh, I could be print decorations. Look at that. Book, glass plates. I didn't know that you could actually print decorations. That's nice. That's fun. Okay. So, yeah. Can we increase the production? Because I would really like to increase the production of this thing. But I'm always worried that something is gonna blow. So let's stop the production here. And let me fiddle a little bit with these knobs. I open this guy, I close this guy. Okay, clearly not that one. Use this one. Use this one. Production 6 liters an hour. Power needed a little bit more maybe. 7, temperature 60. Okay, let's start, see where we're getting it. All right, shall we start? I think it will probably draw more power than my base will allow him to, or my battery will allow. So yeah, once again, I need to set the budget. Oh, and it's already nighttime. So what I'm gonna do here, this time, as said, this is recorded, sorry. I'm gonna increase the budget that is being spent. So how much does it need? The structure needs 37.30. I don't believe that one bit. And I'm supplying 45. I don't buy it. I'm gonna supply 50 now. How much is it going there? 45. Okay. And 4 kilowatts are supposed to go to the vehicles. Yeah. I'm gonna place 0 now. So actually all will go to the base. And that will make sure that our, you know, supplies and everything is working. Low pressure warning, yeah, I know. However, the scrubber, it should be working. Let's start it. No problems? Okay. Seems legit. Okay, guys, you know, this has been a little bit more static episode than my typical stuff. We've gotten sleep deprivation warning, which means we should get some rest. However, the exterior O2 is not much, so I think I will today sleep with my helmet on. How are our plans doing? Are the plans done? No. So I guess they will have to wait for the morning. All right. Expected significant temperature drop. I mean, it has been an early morning because of the storm and everything, so I'm gonna close this one, let the scrubber do its work while I go and have a nice sleep. Alright guys, this is it for this episode. A little bit more static. In the next one we will go out and we will do a lot of exploration, so I hope you will join me and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you very much for watching. This is GrunfWorks signing off.